We'll see the minimum value and maximum value of minimum or maximum value of ax square plus bx plus c. So that is equal to f of x. Now we have to find the minimum and maximum value of f of x, right? So better to do with an example. Suppose f of x is equal to 3x square plus 7x minus 4. And one more example also we have to take. F of x is equal to minus 5x square plus 11x plus 2. So, for which expression? It has minimum or maximum? That we are going to discuss now. And you know complete squaring method? By using that method, that is equal to x square plus 7 by 3x minus 4 by 3 into x square plus, it is 2 into x into 7 by 6 plus 7 by 6 whole square minus 7 by 6 whole square minus 4 by 3. Now it is 3 into x plus 7 by 6 whole square minus 49 by 36 minus 4 by 3. 3 into 7 by 6 whole square minus 3 into, what about LCM? 36. So 49 plus 12 threes, 12 fours, 48. So 3 into x plus 7 by 6 whole square. So this is f of x. So let it be g of x, that is better. Minus 1s, 12s, 90 plus of minus 97 by 12. Now come to second example. G of x is equal to minus 5 as common, x square minus 11x by 5 minus 2 by 5. So g of x is equal to minus 5 into x square minus 2 into x into 11 by 10 plus 11 by 10 whole square minus 11 by 10 whole square minus 2 by 5. So g of x is equal to minus 5 into, what about first three terms? X minus 11 by 10 whole square minus as common 121 by 100 minus of minus plus 2 by 5. Minus 5 into x plus 11 by 10 whole square minus into minus plus 5 into, what about that one? 121 plus 22s, 40 by 100. 40 by minus 5 into x plus 11 by 10 whole square 1s, 20s. 161 by 20. So this is g of x. So what do you observe from that two results? What do you observe from that two results? Tell me. What do you observe from that two results? See, f of x, 3 into x plus 7 by 6 whole square plus of minus 97 by 12. Here, minus 5 into x plus 11 by 10 whole square plus 161 by 20. If you'll observe, plus 3. Even though x plus 7 by 6 negative, square becomes positive. So positive, positive. So their product also positive. So if a positive quantity added to some value, whether it is negative or positive irrespective, a positive quantity added to some number resulting value more than that number or less than that number? A positive quantity added to some number. The resulting value more than that number or less than that number? This is the number. A positive quantity added to this number. Resulting number more than this number or less than this number? More than this number. See, f of x is equal to minus 97 by 12 for x is equal to minus 7 by 6. Understood or not? If you will take minus 7 by 6 here, this becomes 0. 0 into 3, 0. Then f of x is equal to minus 97 by 12. And f of x greater than minus 97 by 12 for all x not equal to minus 7 by 6. Understood or not? If you will take whatever you may consider for x except this value, obtaining value always more than this number. Always more than that number. So, among all such values, who is the least one? If you are giving different values for x, if you are giving different values for x, if you will give minus 7 by 6, it becomes 0, this is the value. If you will give 1 for x, 1 plus 7 by 6 whole square, something you will get, plus this one, the resulting number more than this one or not? Like that you may consider minus 1, you may consider 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, like that different values are giving for x. Always resulting value more than this number only. You may get infinite number of results. Among all results, who is the least value? Who is the least value? You are not getting my point. This is the positive quantity added to this number. The resulting number is always more than this number. In only case, one case, what is that case? X is equal to minus 7 by 6, this becomes 0. This expression is equal to this one. Otherwise, the value of f of x is more than this one. More than this one. So, what is the least value among all those? Minus 97 by 12. That is called minimum value. That is called minimum value. Now come to this question. So, here the conclusion is f minimum is equal to minus 97 by 12, yet x is equal to minus 7 by 6. Come to here. Once go through. The same simplification. Here minus 5 negative. Minus 5 negative. This is positive. Negative into positive. Negative. Negative into positive? Negative. If a negative quantity added to a number, the resulting value is always less than that number. If x is equal to minus 11 by 10, g of x is equal to 161 by 20. If x not equal to minus 11 by 10, what about g of x? Less than 161 by 20. So therefore, what is the conclusion? F maximum is equal to 161 by 20 at x is equal to minus 11 by 10. Sir, I have one doubt, sir. When it is maximum, when it is minimum? Okay, well, I understood, but when it is maximum, when it is minimum? That is my doubt. So how you can clarify? Simple. See, if you will observe these two simplifications, which factor play important role? Which factor? Yes, absolutely. Say loudly. X square coefficients. Completely depending on x square coefficient. Because here x square coefficient is positive, we are getting a minimum value. X square coefficient negative, we are getting a maximum. And one more doubt I have. Sir, every time we are doing like this only? Or is there any formula? So now we are going to derive that formula. See, what is f of x? ax square plus bx plus c. You know complete squaring method, take out a x square coefficient as common, then b by ax plus c by a equal to f of x. Now a into x square plus 2 into x into b by 2a plus b by 2a whole square minus b by 2a whole square plus c by a into x plus b by 2a whole square plus c by a minus b square by 4a square. By taking LCM, a into x plus b by 2a whole square plus what is LCM? 4a square. Then it is 4ac minus b square. Now multiply with a into x plus b by 2a whole square plus a, one time gets cancelled in a square, then 4ac minus b square by 4a. Now the things observed here, if a positive f of x or f minimum value. What is f minimum value? 4ac minus b square by 4a. Yet x is equal to minus b by 2a. Minus b by? When it is minimum, if a greater than 0. If a less than 0, f maximum value. Same. 4ac minus b square by 4a. Yet x is equal to? So we have observed here both minimum value and maximum value having same formula, that is 4ac minus b square by 4a. When it is minimum, if x square coefficient is positive. When it is maximum, if x square coefficient is negative. At what value of x it becomes minimum or maximum? X is equal to minus b by 2a. X is equal to minus b by 2a. At that x value, that is either minimum or maximum, that is depending on x square coefficient. Now see here, what is the equation? A is equal to 3, positive. X is equal to minus b by 2a, minus 7 by 2 into a, minus 7 by 6. Okay, f minimum 4ac minus b square by 4a. 4 into, what is c value? Minus 4. What is a value? 3. Minus b square, 7 square, by 4 into a value? 3. What is the value? 16, 3 is 48, 49. Minus 97 by 12. By using that formula, we can find either minimum or maximum based on x square coefficient. Like that, this one also have to do in that way only. So always, whenever f maximum or f minimum have to find, which formula have to use? 4ac minus b square by 4a. At what value of x it is minimum or maximum? At x is equal to minus b by 2a. Right, so when it is maximum, if x square coefficient is negative. When it is minimum, if x square coefficient is positive. Right.